إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد عباد الله يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in his noble book, O you who believe, enter into Islam completely. Enter into Islam wholeheartedly. نعم يا عباد الله وينبغي لكل مسلم أن يعلم أن ديننا المبارك مبني على معاملات والعبادات نعم يا عباد الله is upon every Muslim to know that the religion of Allah, Al-Islam, is built upon acts of worship and conduct with mankind. نعم يا عباد الله هذا الدين مبني على العبادات والمعاملات Islam is built on ibadat, on acts of worship, but also معاملات, the way our conduct and way you treat one another. العبادات فِيمَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ Your acts of worship is that which is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْمُعَامَلَاتِ فِيمَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ النَّاسِ And your mu'amalat and your conduct and your behavior, that has to do what is between you and mankind. وَهَذَا دِينُنَا نَأَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ And it's upon every Muslim to embark upon al-amrain, upon both of the matters. And that which is in the book of Allah and the sunnah of our messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam indicates this completely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, wal asr innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bil sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he swears by time that all of mankind is in loss except those who believe and do good deeds and they advise one another with the truth and advise one another with patience. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ هَذَا فِي مَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ هَذَا فِي مَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ النَّاسِ Except those who believe and do good deeds, that's between you and Allah. And those who advise one another with the truth, advise one another with patience, that's between you and your conduct and your behavior with mankind. نعم يا عباد الله الأدلة الكثيرة تدل على هذا There's a lot of evidences from the Quran and the Sunnah that indicate this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says Worship Allah and don't associate anything with Him in partners in worship and be dutiful to your parents. Na'am ya ibadallah. This is Islam. Ibadat wal mu'amalat. That's the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is built upon your service and your dedication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also your treatment and your conduct with mankind. Kama qala an-nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna li rabbika alayka haqqan wa li nafsika alayka haqqan wa li ahlika alayka haqqan fa'ati kulladhi haqqin haqqa. Na'am ya ibadallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Verily your Lord has over you a right, and you have over yourself rights, and your family has over you rights. Forgive everyone their true rights. Na'am ya ibadullah. Habi dinuna fa'alam habi ya abdullah. This is our religion. You be aware of that. That the religion of Islam is based on ibadat wal mu'amalat. That this deen is based upon worship to Allah, that's between you and Him, and mu'amalat, your treatment and your conduct, the way you conduct yourselves with mankind. Bal dinuna al-Islam yu'alliqu husnul mu'amalat bi kamal al-iman. Islam, it attaches your good behavior with mankind to complete iman, meaning your iman is naqis until you perfect your mu'amalat and your treatment with mankind. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawm al-akhir, fala yu'zi jarah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever believes in Allah and the last day, then don't harass your neighbor. Meaning if you do that, your iman is deficient, naqis. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ ضَيْفَهُ. Whoever believes in Allah and the last day, then he honor his guest. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. And whoever believes in Allah and the last day, and if he does this, his iman is complete, then he speak good or he be quiet. نعم يا عباد الله بنبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم جعل حسن المعاملات شرطا لكمال الإيمان. Our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made your treatment with people on that which is best and condition for complete iman. بمعنى إيمانك ناقص حتى تتم هذا الأمر. Meaning your iman and your belief in Allah is deficient until you complete this matter. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, La yu'minu ahadukum hatta yuhibba li akhih ma yuhibbu li nafsi. None of you believe, none of you, your iman is complete until you love for your brother what you love for yourself. Na'am ya ibadallah. Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nafa kamal al-iman عن من ساءت معاملته مع الناس. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he negated complete iman for those who have bad treatment with mankind. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والله لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن. قيل من يا رسول الله؟ قال الذي لا يأمن جاره بوائقه. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I swear by Allah, he doesn't believe. I swear he doesn't believe. I swear he doesn't believe. I mean, his iman, his belief is deficient. They said, who, O Messenger of Allah? They said, the one that his neighbor is not safe from his harassment and his annoyment. Aina anta ya Abdullah? Where are you with this, ya Abdullah? Bal su'al mu'amalat ma'an nas qad tamna'a min dukhul al-jannah. Na'am ya ibadallah. Bad conduct with people, it could be a reason for you not entering into Jannah. When Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, kama ja'a fi sahih Muslim, min hadithi Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, la yadukhulu al-Jannah man kana fi qalbihi mithqalu dharratin min kibrin. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he doesn't enter Jannah. Whoever has an Adam's weight of arrogance in his heart. قال الرجل يا رسول الله يحب الرجل أن يكون ثوبه حسنا ونعله حسنة. A man said, oh Messenger of Allah, a man likes that his clothes are nice and that his shoes are nice. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله جميل يحب الجمال. Verily Allah is beautiful and He likes beauty. إن الكبرى الكبر بطر الحق وغمط الناس وغمط الناس وغمط الناس. نعم يا عباد الله. The Prophet said, arrogance, kibr, is denying the truth and belittling mankind and making fun of the people and putting the people down. نعم يا عباد الله. هذا ديننا. ديننا عبادات ومعاملات. العبادات فيما بينك وبين الله والمعاملات فيما بينك وبين الناس. This religion is built upon acts of worship and the way you treat your fellow brother in Islam. Your ibadat, your acts of worship, that's between you and Allah.
And the way you treat mankind, that's between you and mankind. Na'am ya ibadallah, wa huwa tashmal ashya'in kathira. It includes a lot of things. Yashmal ar-rahma wa rifqi ma'an nas. It entails being kind and merciful with people. Wa yashmal ash-shidda wal 'unfi ma'an nas. Wasu' al-mu'amala yashmal ash-shidda. And bad conduct, it contains and entails you being rough and harsh with people. Yashmal al-'adl wal insaf wa yashmal adh-dhulmi wal bughi. It contains you being just and upright, and it contains oppression. Na'am ya ibadallah, yashmal at-tawadu wal kibr. It contains, it entails you being humble or you being arrogant. It entails al-amana wal khiyana. It entails you being just and upright and trustworthy or being disloyal. Ayn anta min hadha ya Abdullah? Where is your place in this? Hadha dinuna al-islam la taghfal ahadun. No one be unaware of this. Yashmal mu'amalatuk awwalan ma'a nafsik. It entails your behavior with your own self. How do you respect your own self? Akrim nafsik, ihtaram nafsak. Honor your own self. Respect your own self. Amam Allah. Thumma ma'a walidayk. Then with your family, with your parents, wa jadda, and your grandparents, wa awladik, and your children, wa akrabin, and your other family and your relatives. Na'am, wal gharib, wal gharib, the ones that you don't know, wal fuqara, wal masakin, and those that are poor. Na'am, wal mu'awwiqin, and those that are disabled. Na'am, ya ibadullah, wal sigar, wal kibar, and the young, and the old, wal yawm. نُنِيرْ أَنْ نَنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ حُسْنِ الْمُعَامَلَىٰ بِأَمْرٍ مُهِمٍ. Today we want to look at good conduct with a matter that's very muhim. حُسْنِ الْمُعَامَلَاتِ مَعَ الْمَرْأَةِ الْمُسْلِمَةِ. We want to look at good conduct with the righteous woman, with the Muslim believer, with the woman that's Muslim. كَيْفَ مُعَامَلَةُ الْإِسْلَامِ مَعَهَا. ماذا أمرك الله ونهاك ربك في هذا الأمر. How did Allah command you and forbid you in this matter? وهذا الأمر يحم الجميع, يحم الرجال ويحم النساء. This is a matter that concerns everyone. لأن النساء المسلمات متحجبات متحشمات ذوات الحوى والحشمة. Because the Muslim women, they are women of hijab. متحجباتٌ متحشماتٌ. They have haya, they have shyness. ما يحب أن تختلط مع الرجال. They don't like to be amongst men. هكذا المرأة الصالحة. من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما جاء في صحيح مسلم قال من حديث عبد الله بن عمرو العاص الدنيا متاع وخير متاعها المرأة الصالحة. This whole world and it is benefit, and the best benefit in this world is a righteous woman. A righteous woman, ما تحب الاختلاف مع الرجال. فاحذر يا عبد الله لا تغفل. Don't be unaware of this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is about Maryam رضي الله عنها. فاتخذت من دونهم حجابا. Now she went and she took a hijab. وحجاب النساء ملابسهن وبيوتهن. And she made a hijab, and hijab are the woman's clothing and their homes. Their homes, يحجبهم عن الناس ويحجب الناس عنهم. Their homes and their clothing make a barrier and a shield between them and mankind. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the righteous woman, وَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُنَّ فَاسْأَلُوهُنَّ مِنْ وَرَاءِ حِجَابٍ. And if you ask them, then ask them from behind a veil, mean behind a wall, from behind a door. نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ هَكَذَا الْمَرْأَةَ الْمُسْلِمَةِ هِيَ مُتَحَشِّمَةِ هِيَ مُتَحَجِّبَةِ. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أجاء في صحيح مسلم من حديثي عن عطاء بن أبي رباح قال لي ابن عباس رضي الله عنه. عطاء بن أبي رباح he said, ابن عباس رضي الله عنه, he said to me, ألا أريك امرأة من أهل الجنة. So I show you a woman that's from the people of Jannah. قلت بلى. He said, I said, of course. قال هذه امرأة السوداء. He said, this black woman over here. أتت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقالت إني أسرع وإني أتكشف فادع الله لي. She said, oh messenger of Allah, I have seizures, I'm sick. I have seizures. And when I have seizures, I become unveiled. Make dua for me. فَقَالِ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِن شِئْتِ صَبَرْتِ وَلَكِ الْجَنَّةِ وَإِن شِئْتِ دَعَوْتُ لَكِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you wish, be patient. Be patient on these sieges, not the shunnuj. Be patient, and for you is Jannah. And if you wish, I'll make dua for you. قَالَتْ أَصْبِرْ. She said, I'll be patient. لَكِنْ لِيَتَكَشَّفْ. She said, accept that I become unveiled. أَيْ لَا أَصْبِرْ عَلَى هَذَا. لَا أَصْبِرْ عَنْ أَتَكَشَّفْ. She said, I cannot be patient. I become unveiled. فَدْعُوا لِي أَلَّا أَتَكَشَّفْ. Make dua for me that I don't become unveiled if I have a seizure. فَدْعَى لَهَا وَرَهُ الْبُخَارِي. For the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for her. فَحْضَرْ مُعَامَلَتَكْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. Be careful of the way you handle a Muslim woman. نعم يا عباد الله وحاذ الأمر يحب الرجال. This is something that concerns all of the men. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at you and your treatment of women. جاء في الصحيح من حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن هذه الدنيا حلوة خضرة. In verity, this white, the life of this world is sweet for those who taste it. It's green and pleasant to the eye. وإن الله مستخلفكم فيه. And Allah placed you in this dunya لينظر كيف تعملون, to see how you conduct yourself. فَاتَّقُوا الدُّنْيَا وَاتَّقُوا النِّسَا. Then beware of the dunya and beware of the woman. فَإِنَّ أَوَّلَ فِتْنَةِ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ كَانَتْ فِي النِّسَا. Verily, the first fitna of the children of Israel was in women. نعم يا عباد الله هذا الأمر معاملة مع النساء أمر يهم الرجال. The issue of how to conduct yourself in front of the Muslim women and with Muslim women, something that should concern every Muslim man. فإن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال كما جاء من حديث أسامة بن مزيد أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما تركت بعدي في الناس فتنة أضر على الرجال من النساء. I did not leave behind me amongst mankind any fitna or any temptation more damaging to the men than the women. هذا أشد فتنة عليك أيها المسكين. This is the most strongest or most severest fitna on you. نعم يا عباد الله. When النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من حديث عبد الله بن مسعود المرأة عورة إذا خرجت استشرفها الشيطان. The woman, all of her is aura. All of her is private. All of her body needs to be covered. If she comes from out the house, if she leaves the house, استشرفها الشيطان. Shaitan uses her as a tool of fitna. نعم يا عباد الله. فمن أول هذه المعاملات مع النساء البعد عن فتنة النساء. The first thing that is wajib on you is to stay far away from the fitna of نساء, from the fitna of women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشًا وَسَاءَ السَّبِيلًا. And don't come close to fornication. Verily, it is a great evil deed. And it's an evil way. And it's an evil mu'amala. When the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا نَحَانَا مُجَرِّدْ عَنِ الزِّنَا فَقَالَ لَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say, don't fornicate. He said, don't come near it. Don't come close to it. لَا تَقْرُبْهُ بِعَيْنِكْ وَلَا بِأُذْنِكْ وَلَا بِلِسَانِكْ وَلَا بِفِكْرِكْ. نعم يا عبد الله. Don't come close to with your eyes, not your ears, not with your tongue, not even with your foot. نعم يا عباد الله. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, كما جاء من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه في صحيح مسلم, كتب على ابن آدم نصيبه من الزنا مدرك ذلك لا محالة. Has been written down and preordained and decreed for the children of Adam, their portion of fornication. He's going to fall into that. La mahala, there's no exception. Al-aynan, zinahuma al-basar, another. He said the two eyes, the fornication of it is looking. Al-udhunan, zinahuma al-istima, the two ears, the fornication of it is listening. Al-lisan, zinahu al-kalam, the tongue, the fornication of it is speaking. Al-yad, zinaha al-batish, the hand, the fornication of it is touching. Al-rijul, zinahu al-khuta, the foot, the fornication of it is walking towards fitna. هكذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والقلب يهوى ويتمنى. He said the heart of mankind desires and wants these things. والفرج يصدق ذلك ويكذب. He said the heart, it desires these things, but the private part, it either confirms it or it rejects it. نعم يا عباد الله. نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يحذرنا في معاملاتنا ويعلمنا في معاملاتنا مع النساء. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he warns us and he teaches us in our conduct with the Muslim woman. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من حديث عقبة بن عامر إياكم والدخول على النساء. I warn you from entering upon the woman. I warn you from the punishment of Allah from entering upon the woman. إياكم إياكم والدخول على النساء. I warn you from entering upon the woman. قال رجل يا رسول الله أرأيت الحظو. One person said, oh, Messenger of Allah, what about the relative of the husband? What about the husband's brother? What about the husband's uncle? What about the husband's cousin? Qala al-hamumat. Qala al-hamumat. This relative of the husband is death, meaning that it's haram. Na'am ya ibadullah. Unzur ila mu'amalatik ya abdullah ma'al mar'a al-muslimah. Look at your dealings and your conduct with the righteous woman. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, as comes from the hadith of Ibn Umar, and hadith Nafil Ibn Umar, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala fil masjid, لو ترقنا هذا الباب للنساء. If we only would leave this door specifically for the woman, لو ترقنا هذا الباب للنساء. If we would only leave this door specifically for the woman, قال نافر. فَلَمْ يَدْخُلْ مِنْهُ إِبْنُ عُمَرْ حَتَّى مَاتَ. For Ibn Umar, he didn't enter this doorway until he died. خَاسْ لِلْنِسَىٰ. نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. When Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يقول, مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلَا يَخْلُوَنَّ بِمْرَأَةٍ لَيْسَ مَعَهَا ذُو مَحْرَمٍ فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ ثَالِثُهُمَا. Whoever believes in Allah in the last day, this is connected to your iman. هذا متعلق بإيمانك بدينك. Whoever believes in Allah in the last day, then don't be alone with a woman except her mahram is with her. For verily shaitan will be the third of them. فاحذر يا عباد الله. نعم. ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يعلمنا ويحذرنا. He teaches us and he warns us from سوء المعاملة. فقال من حديث معقل بن يسار معقل بن يسار رضي الله عنه لأن يطعن في رأس أحدكم بمخيط من حديد خيرا من أن تمسه امرأة لا يحل له خير له خير له أن تمسه امرأة لا تحل له. For one of you to get poked in his head with an iron metal stick, it's better for him that a woman that's not permissible for him to touch him. نعم لا يجوز مصاحبة النساء. And with that, it's not permissible to shake women's hands. نعم يا عباد الله. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى السلامة والعافية.
الحمد لله. حمد كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يعلمنا ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم فيقول للرجال. الله سبحانه وتعالى says teaching the men. وقل للمؤمنين قل للمؤمنين يغضوا من أبصارهم ويحفظوا فروجهم ذلك أزكى لهم إن الله خبير بما يصنعون. Say to the believing men, lower their gaze and protect their private parts. هكذا تحفظ الفرج. نعم يا عباد الله. Lower your gaze. Lower what you look at. Don't look at the woman and protect your private parts.
ذَٰلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ. That's more pure for you. That's better for you. That's safer for you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah is well aware of what you do. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He knows the untrustworthy eye that's sneaking a look. وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. And that which is in your heart that you hide. لَا بُدَّ أَن يَكُنْ رِجَالُ أُمَنَاهُ. You have to be an upright individual, trustworthy. نعم يا عباد الله. والله سبحانه وتعالى يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تدخلوا بيوتا غير بيوتكم حتى تستأنسوا وتسلموا على أهلها. Oh, you who believe, don't enter into houses that are other than your houses until you seek permission. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, innama ju'ila al-istidhan min ajl al-basar. Really seeking permission to enter the house has only been legislated because you might look at something la yahillu lah. You might see something that's not permissible. وَجَاءَ فِي الصَّحِيحِ مِنْ حَدِيثِ سَهْلِ بْنِ سَعْدٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ رَجُلًا اطَّلَعَ فِي جُحْرٍ مِنْ حُجْرِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. That a man, he peeped and he looked through the crack of the door of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مدرا من حديد يحك بها رأسه. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم had a pick in his hand. He was scratching his head with it. فقال للرجل لو أعلم أنك تنظر في بيتي لطعنت به في عينك. If I knew that you was looking in my house, I would poke this in your eye. نعم يا عباد الله احذر من المعاملات. نعم يا عباد الله لابد من الرجولة والمروعة. You have to stand up and be men, upright and honest. قال أنس رضي الله عنه كما جاء في صحيح مسلم أنه أقبل هو أبو طلحة مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Anas radiallahu anhu said that he was traveling who and Abu Talha, and they were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صفية مرديفها على راحلته. And with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was his wife Safiya. She was riding behind him on a riding animal. فلما كانوا في بعض الطريق عثرت الناقة. When they were on their way in the path, the Prophet's camel tripped over. فَسُرِيَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَالْمَرَأَةُ. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم fell down off of the camel. And also the woman fell down. فَاقْتَحَمَا أَبُو طَلْحَى فَأَتَى النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. فَأَبُو طَلْحَى, he jumped off his camel. And he rushed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَقَالَ يَا نَبِيَّ اللَّهِ جَعَلَنِيَ اللَّهُ فِدَاءَكَ. He said, O Messenger of Allah, may Allah make me the sacrifice for you. If anything happens to you, let it happen to me. فَقَالَ هَلْ أَصَابَكَ شَيْءٌ. He said, O Messenger of Allah, did anything happen to you? Are you hurt? قَالَ لَا وَلَكِنْ عَلَيْكَ بِالْمَرْأَةِ. He said, no. But check out the woman. Check out the woman. فَأَلْقَى أَبُو طَلْحَى ثَوْبَهُ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ وَقَصَدَ قَصْتَهَا ثُمَّ أَلْقَى ثَوْبَهُ عَلَيْهَا فَقَامَتِ الْمَرْأَةِ. يَا سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ مِنْ رِجَالٍ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, I'm fine, but check the woman. So Abu Talha, he took his clothing and he put it over his face and he walked in her direction. Then he took the garment and he threw it over her, and the woman stood up. نعم يا عباد الله. أين الرجال الأمناء؟ أين الرجولة؟ أين الشهامة الشهامة؟ نعم يا رجال. Where's the trustworthiness and the uprightness? هل نسينا هذه الصفات؟ Have we forgotten these descriptions? قالت عائشة رضي الله عنها أن امرأة سألت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كيف الغسل بعد المحيض. A woman, she asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم كيف الغسل من المحيض. How does she wash herself? How does she take a bath after she has her menstruation? فأخبرها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم explained to her how to take a bath. خذي, he said, خذي فرصة من مسك فتطهري بها. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take some cotton with some misk and clean yourself with it. قالت كيف أتطهر بها. She said, how do I clean myself with it? قالت تطهري بها. The Prophet said, clean yourself with it. قالت كيف أتطهر بها. She said, كيف, how do I clean myself with it? فستطر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet covered his face. وقالت سبحان الله تطهري بها. The Prophet said, subhanAllah. He covered his face and said, just clean yourself with it. قالت عائشة فعرفت ما أراد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I knew what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wanted. فجبذتها, I took her on the side. وقلت لها تتبعي به أثر الدم. I said to her, following, wipe with it the traces of blood. This is what the Prophet didn't want to say to this woman. This is what the Prophet is telling about. يقول لهذه المرأة نعم يا رجال قوموا وكونوا رجال. Stand up and be men. أمنا بالرجولة ومروعة. نعم يا عباد الله نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى العافية والسلامة. إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. صلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن